Well, I'm not a fan of taxes. So to start off with that, but clearly, I mean, this is a great debate, and I worked with Governor Fife Symington as we worked to eliminate the income tax, because I felt that it was a tax on prosperity and productivity. Also, I worked with Mark Killian, former Speaker of the House, to work to minimize property taxes. Actually, I would have eliminated them if we could have. That was the debate between then Speaker Killian and the governor as to whether we spend our energy reducing property tax or eliminating the income tax, which was the goal. One of the taxes that I think is the most onerous taxes is the personal business property tax. I would eliminate that. We're going to have something on the ballot this time that helps to do that. I hope that passes. I worked with Majority Leader Andy Biggs to get that on the ballot, and we're hoping that that'll pass. But I think, again, we know that in order to create an environment conducive to productivity, you've got to lower the tax burden, lower the regulatory burden, and taxes are a heavy burden, there's no doubt. But one thing that tends to be ignored is the heavy hand of government when it comes to regulatory burdens. I mean, I tease about this all the time. I mean, I find it amazing that I have to have permission for government to go to work. I find it amazing that I have to have a license to shampoo your hair. I think, you know, we've simply gone too far, and the burden is huge. Probably around $1 trillion a year in a stealth tax, because that's passed on to the consumer, you know, for the again, because of government regulation. It's a huge burden, and we really need to take a serious look. I worked with Governor Brewer to put together a panel to look at the regulatory burden. I'm disappointed that it hasn't been a little more aggressive and has not already seen signs of real reduction. But we do have a panel together to look at the regulatory schemes in the state of Arizona to try to reduce those burdens upon business.